final dream in Athens on its all Greek open brackets to me close brackets day. The very, very sad closing of the Sparta Club for who knows how long. It's a very, very sad day. And as always, I've gone to a little bit of effort with my clobber today. I'm linking the opening ceremony jacket with the closing shirt ceremony shirt. For those who are wondering what I'm doing, I know I look like an absolute goose. It doesn't worry me at all. I'm doing it because, as I've said so many times before, I'm an Australian. I'm an Olympian. I'm proud of that. Make of that what you will. Further ado, let me introduce to you a man who accepted an award this morning from Jacques Rog as the Golden Greek. I refer, of course, to Rampaging Roy Slaven. Welcome to the show, Roy. I know you got out early this morning with a metal detector. Did you have any luck?
Yeah, I found some old coins.
Old coins?
Yeah, old Roman coins. No Greek coins, but Roman coins. But they're good. They've got Hadrian on them and the Colosseum.
Uh-huh.
You know, I didn't realise there was a Greek Colosseum, but there was.
Yeah.
It was terrific. We might try and find it this week, we get out with the shovels. Yeah, we've got a week off.
Now, Roy, of course, a very sad day.
It is sad, isn't it?
You know, it wells up. It gets me every time. We've done so many of these, and yet still I can't get used to the idea that tonight the flame will be stubbed out.
I know, all anxiety.
In this magical, moving, closing ceremony, and I believe the Master Olympic pageantry has prepared one final blowout, as we see here in the New York Times. A blowout, I like the sound of it, because let's face it, it's a big bloody joint that's alight down here at the main stadium. And I just hold it up. Like that. Roy, what do you know? What's on the cards? What's on the go, bro, down at the main stadium tonight vis-a-vis shutting her off?
I spent a bit of time with Demetrius last night, who's organising the pageant.
Mm-hmm.
He and Jacques Rog and I made up a little threesome down in the Plaka.
Did you pull any twang, Roy?
I certainly did. I mean, it was a total twang pull at night, if you know what I mean. Things got out of hand, police were involved, you've seen the footage.
You started all that,
Well, I did. I held the first chair at Jacques, because it made no sense. However, Dimitri, my understanding is actually reefer is right. It is a reefer. And it is going to be stubbed out. The stadium will be made to look like an ashtray, which is perfectly fitting for Greece. Unlike the Atlanta toilet.
Yeah.
The athletes will come in. Well, I'm not so sure about that clothing. My understanding is they're going to look like cigarette butts.
Right.
And so they lie about as if they're stubs, and down comes the reefer. Out it goes. But he's a Kubrick freak, so it doesn't end there. I mean, that's just the opening tableau. After that, masks appear out of the seats.
Yeah.
You put them on, eyes wide shut style. Remove your clothing.
And
start dancing and just, you know, find somewhere to get involved.
Well, get to know the person next to you.
Yeah, could well be.
Look, what worries me is the notes that says he wants to get people up and dancing.
Up and dancing, sure.
I mean, with the...
Well, dancing is code for...
Now, I'll tell you what, he's booked the Dick Pound Orchestra.
I know.
What is Dick rehearsing as we speak for the night? Have you got any idea?
Well, I think there's a fair bit of Tijuana brass involved.
Yes.
No surprises there. Tijuana Taxi.
Yeah. That'll be good.
Yeah, and Zorba the Greek.
Zorba the Greek, good.
People will be encouraged to do is that Zorba the Greek dancing, which I like. I never tire of.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
With a bit of bazooki, it'll be great.
Good. Now, of course, once we shut up shop here... Straight over the horizon comes Beijing. I understand it's 1,440 days to go until Beijing. The opening ceremony in Beijing on the 8th of August, 2008. Roy, what can the organisers, the IOC, Rog and that lot, your go-to people, take from Athens that they can tip into Beijing? What are the thumbs-up things as far as you're concerned?
Well, I think people have got to be encouraged. Locals have got to be encouraged to attend. That's the lesson. You don't hold the games when people have left town for holidays. That's just stupid. That's just duh. One. Two, inducements. Either pay people to go. So instead of buying tickets, you get ticket and money, which is a great idea. Either that or threat of jail.
Right.
If you don't attend.
Right.
Or promotion if you do attend.
Right.
You know what I mean? Well, they're like the carrot and stick.
It's carrot and
carrot
stick.
Carrot and stick.
They're very simple ideas, and I know Rog, you know, when I spoke to him briefly after
Understands a simple idea.
I was just going to say, when he emerged from hospital, he was understanding a simple idea.
That's right.
Do you know what I mean?
I
when he came out from anaesthetic, he was great.
Yeah.
Now, look, one of the disturbing things that worries me is that this is the document, this is the document that concerns the mascot competition for Sydney, for Beijing. It really does worry me.
You this that has live two rocks on the back of it.
I know, yeah, I know. Okay. I don't know how that ended up.
No, okay. Forget it. It means nothing. It's accidental.
Now, this is it. Look at all these pages here. Close type. Yes. These are the rules for the mascot competition. Now, as we can see, there were no competition for these guys. And look how well they've worked. I don't know what Beijing's... I mean, I'm starting to worry about Beijing already.
I know, I know. Well, the lesson is with mascots, you don't have to come up with an idea.
Absolutely. Do you know what worries me even more is when I look at the judging committee for the mascots in Beijing, there's three. It's a judging committee of three. Three disturbing people. The Norwegian ambassador to Beijing and China in general is on that list.
Well, what would he know?
We've got Prince Albert of Monaco.
Well, what would he know? Even less.
And we've got, of course, the chairman is Kevin Gospel.
Well, that... Oh, no, really?
Yeah.
Bloody hell, that's it, the big three.
The big three. Talk about a threesome that'd get it wrong. Straight off the bat, there. But, Roy, will you be entering?
I certainly will. Yeah, yeah, yeah. My understanding is you're looking for an idea that is commercial.
Commercial?
That's something that kids will get involved in.
Right. Have kids gotten involved with these guys?
No, 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 no.
Why not?
No, that's appealing to sick adults, and I don't...
Right.
I don't know, maybe, I don't know, a funny toilet paper.
Funny toilet paper! Hang on a minute.
Haven't we already done it?
That's right. Now, Roy, of course, Australia's done incredibly well at these games. In fact, it's our best games ever, as we were saying the other night. It makes the effort here just really does make Sydney look very, very ordinary from our athletes, doesn't it? But there's a disturbing report in the paper today from the Executive Director of Australian Sports Commission 1, Mark Peters, who says that the future of Australian Olympic success is under the threat from growing obesity rates in Australian children and the lack of focus in schools on sporting skills. Roy, it's a chilling warning. It's a chilling warning. I was disturbed this morning. In fact, I checked the wobble.
We haven't slept, have we?
No, no. I felt very faint when I read that, and I believe that it carries... There is a germ of truth there. I mean, obviously, Australia and weightlifting haven't been used in the same sentence here at these games very often. So as I can see the bulky kids getting involved in that.
Oh, there's something for the fat kids. No, the fat kids will be looked after.
Once your Greco-Roman program gets underway, once again, heavyweight kids will come to their own.
Yeah.
But do you believe that Peter's position is right when there's obviously a disturbing lack of focus on sporting skills in schools?
For how long? For how long have we been asking?
Yes.
For compulsory sport in schools.
Oh, indeed.
Compulsory sport. And compulsory doesn't mean you can do it if you want to do it.
No.
Compulsory means you've got to do it.
You've got to do it.
You've got to do it. You know what I mean? If by the time you're 13 or 14, you cannot run 100 metres in less than 10 seconds.
Wow.
Less than 10 seconds.
Yes.
You don't go on.
Yes.
You're just thrown to the ash can of time. You're just hurled out. Put in the gutter where you belong for people to spit on you and crap. You know what I mean?
Right.
We don't want failures. We won't tolerate failure.
Can I just...
That lesson's going to be rammed home in schools.
Now, Roy, can I just say that I believe we put too much emphasis on the problem of schools. You know, I believe the whole community has to take this on a burden.
Responsibility?
Responsibility.
Community, take responsibility
for the fitness levels around the community.
So whenever you see a fat kid,
you boot him up the gate. But having said that, I believe as the population ages, so the age of participants in the Olympic Games will age, so we'll be able to have fat old people in the Olympic Games as well. You know, it would be great if
you mean oldies are our future?
Oldies are our future. I mean, I make this pledge today that Roy and I will turn out in the double skulls in Beijing.
We are.
We may not make it. Roy, it's going to be a very exciting time the next 4 years, and Well, as we shut up shop here in the Sparta Club, yeah. we need to turn to our awards, and these are a popular part of our programs, and I think you've spent up most of the night that wasn't down fighting in the plaka or having your twang pulled down there all night. You've assembled your top five personalities from these games. Who are they, Roy? I'll do a plate for each of them.
They are as follows, ladies and gentlemen. The personalities of the Athens game 2004 are... Number five, no surprises, the Lion of Athens. Congratulations, Lion. Superb performance he really put in. Number four, the great minstrel sailor, Lars Klepich. As far as we know, that was Lars in the top right-hand corner of your frame. Number three, no surprise again, Dick Powell. Who managed again to pull everybody's twang more than anyone. Number five, Kevin Gosper. Hey! Nobody runs a press conference like Kevin. Nobody keeps a tighter rein.
Give us an impression,
on
Roy.
The gonads of the world than Kevin Gosper. Oh, Lordy. That's enough of that. You sit down. Hey, what are you doing there? Get it back over here. Thank you very much. Press the button when the light goes red. Give your name, age, etc. He's perfect. Number one, the personality, outstanding personality, and thank you very much for all the work you've done. It really has been a tremendous effort. ladies and gentlemen, the chef de mission for Australia, John Coates.
I feel better now. We, yep. we did encourage people to last night to buy the John Coates pin,
yes.
Which was manufactured. I think we made 400,000 of them to raise money for the Athletes Welcome Home Parade. Obviously available in gold, silver and bronze at appropriate prices. We've got some of them there.
Yep.
Roy, how's the pin selling? Before we go to some vision, I know you were trying to trade them. What is the story? What is the current state?
Hotcakes. Does the term hotcakes mean anything to you?
Yes.
And I think enough money will be raised for the ticker tape homecoming parade for our heroes.
Isn't that tremendous?
I think we're going to reach the mark of $4 million to be raised, I think, by 10 a.m. tomorrow morning. so that our heroes can, you know, the valiant cars can be there to... the Chryslers will be there to run them up and down every street in Australia. I think it's a great idea.
Now, speaking of Coates, obviously he's been flat out our chef de mission. However, he has come up with an interesting hoise, which is a tribute to tin. The tin, of course, being awarded to the fourth place getters. And at these games, Australia has achieved not only a record golden haul, but a staggering 20 fourth place finishes.
Fantastic.
Roy, it's a terrific thing that Coachy has done. He's been up all night editing this together for the show. Look, let's go to the break here on the final show.
And you assess how appropriate it is. This was shown to the athletes last night.
And as we go to the break, here is our tribute to tin.
I don't want to talk if it makes you feel sad, and I understand you've come to shake my hand. I apologize if it makes you feel bad seeing me so tense, no self-confidence. But you see, the winner takes it all. The winner takes it all. So the winner takes it all. And the loser has to fall.
Yes, the lovable duo really have talked to kids, and it's just tremendous to imagine what lies ahead of us mascot-wise in Beijing. Roy, the only real disappointment, I think, and I speak as an Australian Olympian, proud of it.
Make of that what you will.
Yes. Is the sailors. Now, the sailors were obviously in lighter airs than what they might normally be used to. And the other thing was they had a psychologist. Do you think the psychologist held them back?
Well, how did we go? Did we get anything? Blot. Was it blot? Blot, blot, blot. Not even. No tin, even.
No. Oh, well, they might have got tin. I think one of the
playoff coaches
put together, he had to include somebody. And so,
yeah. You know, well, I think it's an equipment problem. I think we brought the wrong sails, the wrong boats.
The wrong crew.
And the wrong crew. apart from that, everything was terrific. Mm. The psychologist, you couldn't fall in. You've got to remember, most of our team had never sailed before.
That's true, and we're just lucky enough to be here at the time.
Yeah. And they've had a whale of a time.
That's right. And speaking of a whale of a time, it's always great to get along to a night of gymnastics. And look, we were so lucky to be there when we saw the cream of the crop during the week. It was just fantastic. Let's go and have a look at the gymnastics now. Yes, and now welcome to the business end of the competition on gymnastics, artistics, men's floor routine. It's been an exciting competition so far. Jovchev from Bulgaria up now in the red. Look, obviously, judges are looking for a little bit of something out of the ordinary, and Jovchev is the sort of person who's likely to give it to you, Roy. Chico rolls to get us underway, and a beautiful step into the corner there.
A wide walk, yeah. Good to see the wide walk back. He's known as the old man of the field, and look at that tremendous work there with a sort of half hello boys there going to crazy legs and spinning date.
Beautiful spinning date. He can spin and go up for the crazy date, yep. Longer than anybody else I've seen. Right. Beautiful work there from the Bulgarian.
Hello, boys.
Hobbity-hobbity-hobbity-hobbity-hobbity-hobbity-hobbity. Love that flat bag.
Beautiful work.
Checks the clock for the flat bag.
Yep. Textbook flat bag. And here we see an inverted hello, boys, with a closed door.
And it's a beautiful manoeuvre.
Oh, and a stab.
And a reverse batted salve. And look, he's an excitement machine. He's been exciting people for a long time.
Wide walk to the corner.
And here he comes now with another pass down the...
Oh, hello.
A held half Harry with a bit of hello boys involved.
Yes,
there.
I haven't seen a held half Harry.
That judge in the corner got a terrific eyeful there. And in motion again, Chico Roll.
He's nailed it.
He pulled that right out.
A little bit of a stumble. It was a little bit low, HG. A little bit low.
But that's a terrific routine. Look, that was the last chicken in the shop, Roy. As we see this come along here, he's got the fries going out with that. And the roll, the last chicken in the shop. And to take home a bit of dessert, Mars bar deep fried. Was that bloody good, wasn't it? Look at that.
Very, very good. You should be happy with that. Yes, I am. It's a little bit low. Thanks for the wave, fella. The old man on the circuit. Could this be his last go round?
Dragulescu now there from
Mystery Man. Mystery Man.
He's very, very... with the new guard from the old...
The new generation.
He steps onto the mat. Obviously, realised he wasn't quite where he wanted to do. Took another step. Remember, looking for something a bit special here. We're underway now. Chico rolls. Double Chico roll.
Batted sad.
To start off with, gives the judge in the corner there the rear end. And...
He's going to go next.
And we're across. We're in action.
Spinning half Harry. Spinning half Harry.
Not quite where he wanted to finish.
Wide walk. And he's not quite in the corner where he wants to be.
And so slightly off centre here, Dragulescu. Yeah. He's coming across now with a lot of Chico rolls. Yeah. Batted salve. That must have hurt Roy.
Yeah. Spinning date. Spinning date with a hint of hello, boys. Flat bag.
And beautiful arm work here, as you'd expect.
Look, the judges appreciating it there, too. Boys in the wrong direction.
Indeed, they'll mark that down, Roy.
The judge didn't see it at all.
We saw it. We loved it. Best hello boys we've seen all competition.
For sure.
Because he pointed it straight at us.
He's half Harry!
High marks there. He got plenty of height. Nah, Farry didn't hold it, though.
No.
If he could have grabbed the legs, that would have been wonderful there. He's in motion. Yep. He's finishing up now. And that's
a little bit of a stumble.
Turn up at the cash register, a $4.50 routine in cost. Let's have a look at any marks, Roy. How are you rating this as we see? There it is.
There it is, the half Harry the horse. Beautiful work.
He almost got hold of one leg there. I think he was trying to get hold of two legs.
That's where they've marked him down, I think, HG, and the slightly flawed half Harry.
9787. And now the excitement machine from
Canada.
Yeah, indeed, from Canada. I was thinking of the Great Plains of Canada. Schufelt, Calgary, part of the Calgary Stampede of vaulters and gymnasts.
Well, he's chosen traditional music, which is good. The judges all like that.
He's underway. He's a terrific routine to start with. He almost used exactly the amount of mat.
Wide walk.
Back into the corner. I'm going out again now.
Yep.
And here I come. He's underway. The beautiful Chico rolls.
Yes.
He's got that. Oh, one off the top there, and he fried that Mars bar beautifully. Now it's all before him.
Where is he
back
now?
He goes.
Where is
with
he
a
now?
Twist, batted sav.
Batted sav, half batted sav. Not completed with to my view.
Well,
a couple of wide walks. Didn't know where he was going. He's not the corner.
He didn't have the mayonnaise
with
that
sav. Bit of a goose
sav.
There. Bit of a goose. Here we go.
There's beautiful layup. And the return batted sav.
Return flat batted sav. Straight at the judge, and the judge is enjoying that.
Yes.
Has a bit of a scratch to compose himself.
Hello, boys.
Hello, boys. Closing the door.
Not expecting company up there.
Yep.
And rolls into the corner.
Corner, yep.
With a beautiful line there on the gymnast. And look,
presents himself to the judge.
I saw a little bit of sauce.
Half-wide walk, yep.
I saw a little bit of sauce with that sav, Roy, which I liked.
I liked.
So the final pass here. Away he comes now. Chico rolls.
Spinning
deep prize Mars bar. Straight into the
nails
corner there.
Beautifully.
That was terrific work there. And I'll be interested to see how the judges mark Schufelt
from Calgary.
Because
there was no half Harry. No acknowledgement of Harry the horse
and
at all.
No standing as we watch. No standing hello boys, which has now become de rigueur at this level. And straight into the corner. Well within the reservation. And... oh, what have we got? A tie at the top of the board. 9787.
They'll have to look at a count back. They'll have to look. Oh, God, they're gutless, these judges. They'll have to look at a count back here.
They will. They'll have to go to a count back. We leave you with the competition poised marvellously with Dragulescu and Schufelt tied. And I'd love to see a jump off for it, Roy.
For sure. A golden jump.
Yes, well, some of the excitement there that's been unfolded in the gymnastics here in the games of the 28th Olympiad. There'll be more of the final episode of The Dream in Athens right after this. See if I can get all this right. Gold in the 200-metre freestyle. Gold in the 400-metre freestyle. Silver in the 4x200 freestyle relay. Bronze in the 100-metre freestyle. You know who I'm talking about? I'm talking about Ian Thorpe. Ian, thanks for coming in on the last day of competition here and this rather, what would you call, emotional occasion.
Yes.
And look, we might divvy up the plates, so you've got a plate there to break at an appropriate time. I'll have one and Roy can get on loaded as well.
Yeah.
We'll do it in a minute. Now, look, Beijing obviously looms, and I know you committed yourself to Beijing, and I saw some figures on what Grant Hackett has set himself for the next 4 years. He's going to swim roughly 75 kilometres per week. This makes 15,000 kilometres in the next 4 years, i.e. he could swim from Athens to Sydney. Have you got that sort of program mapped out for yourself?
Look, I've decided I'm actually going to start my swim home rather than taking the charter flight back. But yeah, I'm going to have a break now and then work out what I want to do, and I'll have a few kilometres clocked up before then.
And is it too early to tell how you would make a decision about events, you know, that you'd participate in? When it's hard to know how these things would go, but when do you think you might be able to work out what your program would be?
Well, I'm going to have a break and then sit down with my coach and, you know, we'll sort it out then, you know, work out what I want to do. And, you know, whatever I decide now, it's kind of, it's in the plan for 4 years' time rather than just for the next year.
Right. Well, you know, just speaking personally, I'd love to see you have a go at the 50. I think that if you could beat Gary Hall Jr. in the 50 in Beijing, that would be a dream come true, speaking personally. But one thing is swimming, obviously, is a big thing, but then that generates this other problem for you, what I laughingly call the Thorpe Empire. And how many of the products that you endorse do you actually use? For instance, have you got the undies on today?
I have.
You have?
I don't want to show you that.
Oh, no, that's all right. That's all right. I mean, the pictures say it all. I don't need to see it anymore.
I like the products that I endorse, and I do use all of them. And most of the time, or half the time at least, I have them on. So, you know. It's been a long games, hasn't it?
Yes.
It's been a long games. But, yeah, I'm proud of the products that I represent.
No, I understand that. Now, you're launching yourself into what I'd laughingly call the In Thorpe world of drinks.
Yes.
Which you're going to aim at the populous nations of the world. And how many of these have you tasted? How many have you sent back? And how many actually are there?
I went through the whole, you know, research and development with everyone else. So when there was trials for them, I was drinking the drinks as well. And most of the time they got it right. And, you know, occasionally we tried to tweak it a little bit just so it was a little more palatable.
And how many drinks, though, in the range, in the Thorpe range?
To start with, there'll probably be six drinks.
Six drinks. Now, look, we've knocked up some ideas, you know, in terms of marketing here. As you can see, it's just a simple blue drink, trading on the fact that we made you the Lion of Athens,
okay.
The Lion of Athens sports water. Is this anything what they look like? Have we got it anywhere near right?
It looks good, but thank goodness I've had a little bit longer to work on this than what you guys have, so the bottles are a little more presentable than that.
Very good. Roy?
Yes, look, I noticed just when you arrived here today, Ian, I mean, every half-baked dickhead wants to have their photograph taken with you.
Yeah,
does that wear you down? Does it wear you down, do you think? Oh, God almighty.
I mean, it is hard at times, but, you know, mind you, I mean, people wouldn't want to have their photo taken with me if I didn't swim so good.
That's
here.
Right. It's the burden of fame.
I'm more than happy to do it.
Yeah, OK. Now, you took on a new coach to get to Athens. Tracy Menzies did a great job. With Beijing, would you look to another coach?
not really.
No.
I'm pretty happy with where I'm... Actually, I'm very happy with where I'm at the moment with my coach. But
right.
Well, are you making an offer, are you?
No, well, yes, I am. What happens? Essentially, coaching swimmers is very bloody simple. In you get. See you in half an hour when you come.
Nice.
I'll run the clock over. You do all the work. The problem must be doing so many laps is boredom. Boredom in the water.
It does, yeah, it does become a little tiresome at times. I mean, we're in the pool and, you know, there's not really too many people that we can talk to.
Well, that's right. Have you thought of tapes? I used to swim with tapes. To give yourself something to listen to, music or information, something like that. Have you thought of tapes?
No, I've thought about it, but I've also thought the second you dive in, it's not going to work.
No. You can get out of the water stuff now. Maybe we could work on designing one and you could market it. And
all right, more than happy to. Another product that you want me to put out there. That's all
well,
right.
Well, why not? Well, why not?
Yeah.
I certainly think that could work. Now, are you a party animal, Ian? Have you had a chance to party and party hard since the first week of competition?
Yeah, I have. It's either yes or no. I have been partying quite a lot.
Yeah. Little sleep, out all night, that sort of thing?
Little sleep, out all night, go watch sport in the day.
Now, when are you going to get back in the pool? When are you going to start taking Beijing seriously? You've had a week off. Has Tracy had a word to you?
Taken it seriously already, and I'm seriously considering getting back in the pool sometime soon.
Sometime soon?
Yeah.
Like, as soon as you get home?
Like,
within an hour?
As soon as I have a little bit of a break. Is that good enough?
Yeah, I know, that's good enough.
Okay.
Now, Ian, coming into the Olympics, you made some comments which I think FINA, the World Swimming Authority, didn't approve of concerning drugs in swimming. How many people have you swum against here on drugs, do you think?
Thousands.
Thousands, yes. And does it surprise you now the spread of world swimming in terms of medals? You know, I often scratch my head and think, well, who said they could swim? Who allowed them to have a pool? You know, that sort of thing. Does this often surprise you, the medals, where the medals come from in terms of nationalities?
I mean, there always are some surprises at the Olympics, but I mean, I think it's good that the medals are being spread, you know, rather than just being in the hands of the US and Australia and Germany. You know, it's being spread across the board a little bit more. So I think it's good for the sport.
Would you consider taking on different disciplines in maybe butterfly? I've always wanted, personally speaking, to have side stroke reintroduced to the
audience.
Side stroke, I thought it was a very attractive style.
And I think it's underappreciated as well. I mean, it takes a skill to be able to do that. And, you know, the eloquence that's required to actually be able to compete in that event. You know, yes. I'd want to be doing it. And I'll start training tomorrow.
Side stroke, I'm in. Bloody good.
Well, that's fantastic. Well, look, it's been great to have you on the show. Obviously, the last one's always with a tear in the eye. But as a special super-duper souvenir, a double pin-off for you, Ian. Firstly, the John Coates pin, which you'll wear with pride. That's the first one.
Well, I want to put it on now.
Well, you'll be able to do that. That's the first one. No.
I'm just checking.
That's the first one of those we've ever given away, followed very rapidly by the 24-carat gold spade slash shovel, which is a souvenir of your time with us here on the Dream in Athens.
Thank you very much.
And Roy?
Yes, as well, you get this, the golden shovel toilet paper, Ian, to take home with you and wipe with pride.
I will.
And before we go, of course, on the count of three.
You ready?
All right, I'm ready.
Here we go. One, two, three. Can you please take been a very romantic games, a very romantic place, Athens, Roy, isn't it? And, you know, no surprise.
There's been a lot of bottom patting.
There is, yeah. Touching people on the bum seems to be the go here at these games.
It does. Doesn't get you into trouble here, does it?
No, it doesn't.
Tapping someone on the bum can open doors.
I tell you what, the coach pin, once you get it in situ, I don't know whether we can pick that up, once you get it on situ on
the
light,
it does,
there. That's absolutely fantastic, isn't it? I mean, that is something you could march down that victory parade in Australia, just pointing there, and people would absolutely stand and salute and throw rubbish at you. It's that sort of great, just entree back home. Now, synchronised swimming. Look, we haven't had a chance, I'm afraid. We've had so many emails and requests for it, and really, what can we do? We're just a couple of buffheads on the burble and it's escaped our gaze. But to correct that remedy or to correct that problem, we've got the Russian routine from the synchronized swimming pool. It's just superb. Let's go to it now. And so to the synchronized swimming and one of the glamour teams. They haven't been beaten in 15 years. The Russian team here set themselves for a blast. Roy?
They've come to sync, haven't they, HG? They're a marvellous team. Terrific people, and they're not too mannered at this stage. Ooh. They've gone completely rococo slash mannered on us, haven't they?
Well,
still, I'll accept that sort of amount. You've got to give them a little slack. Cut them some slack.
Now, they had originally hoped the Dick Pound Orchestra would be here to do I Am I Said. Sadly, Dick sent over a CD of Song Sung Blue. Look.
Ooh, hang on a minute. Having sent over the CD, it looks like the CD has stopped. The whistle's gone.
The whistle gone.
It's a full start.
Full start. Now, Roy, look, they're a bit of sixes and sevens here in the Russian manner.
This is going to upset their concentration. Oh, there's the stern official.
And the stern official, but not knowing where to look, and it's...
Here comes another stern official.
The complete breakdown in the public address system has blown the girls back onto dry land, just as I was developing a point about performing to Song Song Blue.
Yeah. Well, let's just set that to one side. It's the problem here of the tape or CD they sent is obviously scratched.
Uh-huh.
Dick Pound scratched it accidentally in transit. I've never known this to happen before. A bit of a rueful grin there. Now, this bloke, picking his nose, the pick-nose bloke, he's the...
He can't leave it alone, Roy, can he?
No, he's obviously the heavy hitter.
Uh-huh.
The heavy marshal.
I think they're going to start again and go back to the beginning. And Roy, it's Conflab behind the scenes here. Yeah. I hope we can get a shot of the problem material as we see this fantastic costume up close.
Well, they're getting cold. They're getting cold.
That costume isn't warm, is it, Roy?
No, they're wet and the wind's blowing.
And they feel like stupid. People, because they can't get it right. And a lot of these girls, of course, were vaguely offered the choice of synchronized swimming or 15 years of community service.
The Vice Trust is still trying to piece together what went wrong. Has the offending CD been cited?
No, I don't know.
Has it been recued? Do they have the facilities to be able to cope with this? Why aren't they given towels or something to...
Track suits.
Yeah.
They've only got a nose clip to keep them warm.
I know,
That rather garish costume with this.
And they're going for gold here. I mean, it's not like this is just a qualifier.
Have you seen them in practice, Roy?
I have, and they're sensational. They're absolutely sensational. And there was no music when I saw it.
Right, so you had no idea. I was going to say,
there's the CD. Well, okay, this is a replacement CD. It might be a replacement song.
Oh, well, let's hope they go back to what I said. This will be very, very interesting. I wonder the DPO's cut and a version of I Am, I Said in the intervening minutes.
This is exactly as they performed it before. Brilliant. Isn't that extraordinary?
Absolutely brilliant. First class. They're underway here in the Russian Federation synchronized swimming routine to Neil Diamond. And
that's good. Okay.
Firstly, Roy, Neil Diamond in Russia, how big an act is he?
Yeah, I had no idea how big Neil was until I'd spoken with the girls through an interpreter, obviously, just a few days ago. And it's not so much Hot August Night that blew him away, but Live at the Greek. The subsequent album, live album, and they thought, well, Live at the Greek, we're in Greece, we're in Athens. You can see what their thinking was. You can see it, can't you?
Yes. And look, it's a terrific routine that's now just starting to get into the lyrics. And Song Sung Blue, everybody knows one.
Well, that's true. It's a truism, isn't it? But now, how to interpret Song Sung Blue, everybody knows one. This is the challenge to the Russian girls here.
It is. And how do you think they're going with the music?
Well, for a start, I would have thought Song Sung Blue, you'd have a glum face on. You wouldn't be grinning.
No.
So I'd mark them down here for a start. But we don't know how the lyrics translate into Russian.
Well, willow and pillow. Song Sung Blue, weeping like a willow. Song Sung Blue, crying on my pillow. Can you see that in the choreography?
I'm not seeing that at all.
No. Do you feel that's a problem for the girls?
All I'm seeing is the blue of the water.
Oh, well, I've got that too. Yes, don't get me wrong. I can see the blue here. And as you point out, the grin's rather mocking the lyric, isn't it?
Hang on a minute. Looks like the CD's gone again.
Roy. I mean, somebody... Here it is. Back again. Oh, I wonder where we are. They'll be completely lost, won't they, Roy? If they kept going
They'd be down there working... Oh, great height. Yeah. I don't know if that was planned or not. It wasn't in the routine when I saw it before.
No. They're off the reservation here a little bit. They're performing with a little bit of improvisation here, which is good to see.
It is good to see. Oh, they're back in sync now. But how the judges view that era, it's a little unclear.
And what a rescue, though, by the girls there. Tremendous.
Terrific rescue. But maybe, HG, maybe they're taking the contrary position that it's too easy to get swept away with a Song Sung Blue, and the way to combat the blues is to have a bit of a grin and a swim.
I suppose it is.
Is that it?
I suppose it is. Now,
so it's a counterpoint.
Yes, to the melody and the lyric.
Yep. But they're in terrific synchrony there, you'd have to say.
Just marvellous. And Roy...
And they can hear the water. Sorry, hear the music underwater, of course. People have asked me, you know, can they hear underwater? Well, obviously they can. There are speakers underneath.
Blasting it out. Well, intermittently blasting it out.
Which can affect your timing because sound moves more quickly through water than it does through air.
They must accommodate for that.
Yeah, you'd have to accommodate for that. You'd have to. And that's generally why people go with 4/4 tracks like this, nice and simple, so that you can accommodate the water variance.
Now, Roy...
Is it gone? It's going back to the start.
Musical. Well, that's pure pound. And, of course, there's a couple of Olgas, a couple of Anastasias, a couple of Marias, an Anna, and a Elena, and Maria, there, off that throw there. Roy, did you think that was right? Did you think coming off the side like that?
Well, people are looking at it from the camera. We're not. We're as it's seeing it, as the judges see it. Really, that was ordinary because she came off at a really odd angle, didn't she? It wasn't straight.
It was a chilling angle.
Yeah. Thank you.
It really was disconcerting. Yeah. In fact, I know I saw somebody at the end just faint.
I know. I'm sure the judges will cut them a bit of slack, as we might have mentioned earlier, because of the kerfuffle.
With the CD.
Yeah, the embarrassing failure of organisation.
Well, you see, this is what happens when you get amateurs involved.
Yeah. Sure. I mean, the piggy nose bloke.
Yeah, the piggy nose bloke. He's a complete amateur and slightly silly with it.
Yeah.
It's got to go to professional status. And there's the applause, the tremendous applause. And there's the one who didn't get in the pool. The Russian people here off their faces with delight.
Yeah. Gee, they did well. They're real Trojans, aren't they? Trojans.
Really, they soldiered on, Roy. Trojans are very good. Mm. Especially with light at the Greek Trojans. It's terrific to see them getting out of the pool here. Very, very delighted with the difficulty of the routine. And Roy, the marks.
Well, let's see. Bloody hell. Couple of 9.9
on the Tico Merit gear.
Yeah.
And what about your Artie, artistic and tens. Five tens. Look at that. They can't believe them. What a thrill. Obviously, first place at the moment. Never mind the glitches. Tremendous work.
Tremendous work. Thanks, kids.
I still worry about that score, you know. Because let's face it,
you know, most of the time they were just waiting for, you know, things
I know, well, artistic merit, I would have given it naught.
True.
Song Sung Blue, I didn't get it.
No, it was hardly on the beat either. You know, I mean, they were struggling there.
I know.
But one of the great sports here, and I use that word sport advisedly.
And great advisedly.
Indeed. There'll be more of the final Dream in Athens right after this. Yes, and something happened last night that hasn't happened to an Australian team since 1956. We got a silver in the 4x400 relay, and we've got three of the team members with us now. We've got John Stephenson, Mark Ormrod, and Clinton Hill, the silver bullet. Yes, thanks, boys, for coming in. I know you've been in the perpendicular for some time now. Look, 7th to 2nd, you qualified 7th. You finished up 2nd. Did you know you could improve that much? And when did you know you could improve that much? Probably when you crossed the line. But have a go at that, Clinton.
Look, our team, we had pretty good confidence in ourselves, you know. I mean, the press didn't write us up too much, which was good, so it was sort of the dark horse of the race. But, I mean, we had a chat in the morning and... you know, we changed the order a bit, shuffled us around. So we were confident in our own ability and it showed through in the end, so.
And how much did you improve from the heat to the final?
Just a little over 3 seconds, I think.
3 seconds.
Yeah.
And is that everybody, when they look at their times, is that what happened to everybody improved or just one person really let go?
No, I think especially the relay, it's definitely a team effort. It doesn't matter if one guy runs real fast, but the other three guys also have to put in effort to make the overall time, and it's evident with the Americans, that's why they're so far ahead. But
and you guys live in different parts of Australia. How do you get together to train?
Oh, I moved to Sydney 2 years ago, and I trained with Clinton and Patrick, so we were used to each other for a while, but Mark trains in South Australia.
And the I noticed in some of the comments you made last night, people don't appreciate how hard the event is, you know, in the preparation of it. Just if you could flesh that out, tease that out a bit.
Well, me and Pat were talking before our race, just when we were sitting after lunch, and we were asking, why do we do this event? Because it just physically, because me and him were the only ones to be sick after the heat, and we're always sick, so me and him were thinking, we've got to do this again tonight. So but then we got a silver medal, so we didn't feel the...
You didn't feel sick?
No, we were fine. We were too busy carrying on, so...
Roy?
Yeah, look, as you mentioned, 56 was the last time that we got a medal in the relay athletics. And part of that team was Lord Gosper. Lord Kevin Gosper was part of that team. Has the Lord been in touch? Did he phone you and say, listen, blokes, you're fantastic, well done?
No, it's been pretty quiet, actually.
Do you want to break a plate?
Yeah, give me one of those.
One each.
Right on. Have a go. Now, apart from breaking plates, what do you do for team bonding? How do you get the team to bond?
We handcuff him.
Yeah. Well, then what do you do?
And we attack him in the shower. So he showers.
Well, that sounds fantastic preparation. What do they do to you in retaliation?
No, I'm the one doing it, so they can't.
We can't do anything. I'm handcuffed. So what can I do?
Oh, okay. Yeah. So you're handcuffed, you're attacked, and you're the...
I'm the one attacking.
And what does Pat do?
He just says, boys, boys, we've got to run tonight, so he's
settle
a serious
down.
One.
Settle down.
Who's the team leader, if there is one? Who's boss of the troop? Who's the
really
captain?
One.
There isn't really one. We all get out, put our 5% worth in, so there's no one that really takes control as such.
Now, what about changing the baton? It seems to me that's one of the vital things. There's running and there's passing the baton. Do you do much passing the baton training?
See, for us, we can't, because we can't simulate the fatigue factor unless we do it in a fatigued environment.
Yes.
So, and you don't want to do that too often, especially leading
Why
up
not?
To a major.
Why not? I'd have you in a fatigued environment 364 days of the year, passing a baton continually.
On paper that would work well, but, you know, the bodies would just shut down. They're already shutting down now. It's time for us to have a bit of a break. But, look, it might be worth an idea.
But we're all good with our stick work anyway.
Yeah. Yes, you would.
Our stick work is fantastic.
Stick work's good?
Stick work's great.
Well, the stick work was pretty bloody good last night.
It was indeed. Now, look, let's face it, you have an opportunity here to cash in on your success and sponsors. Now, you know, let's face it, everybody has something they want, and you've got an opportunity to ask, you know, various people out there in a position to give it to you. Yeah. What would you like out of this?
I need some hair products, because my hair is really good.
Hair products? Your humility is admirable, and the lack of wanting to load up the burden on the sponsors is impressive. Yes. But you've got to aim a bit higher than hair products. I mean,
hair products, good though. It's a good start. Hair product and anything else?
Car.
What about a car?
4x4.
4x4.
4x4. Plates. Well, now we've tentatively called you the Silver Bullets. That would get a beer manufacturer on side, wouldn't it? What about beer? Would you think about advertising beer?
I mean, drink.
No, well, don't tell them that. The public doesn't have to know that.
Yeah.
You know, you've just got to be seen with the beer.
And the hair products.
Absolutely. Now, I'm a post-race. That's the first thing you want to grab is a, you know, a cold
drink. Yeah. Now, you've said that one of your heroes, John, is boxers. Boxers. You love boxers. Have you spent much time with the boxers?
No, one of the guys I used to train with made the Olympic team.
Yeah.
And my ex-coach mate was the coach for the Olympic team.
Yeah.
So I got to see, and he was unlucky, he got fourth in his fight as well. But as far as other teams, no, I haven't. My friend said they saw Evander Holyfield last night, but no, I haven't, no.
No, okay. Mark, I think the boxers have really been treated badly. The official, the judging has been poorly. Just appalling.
It's pretty bad.
Mm. And Mark, do you have any similar heroes?
Just us blokes.
Just us blokes.
Very good.
Isn't that beautiful?
Very good. Very good. Would you like another plate? Here you go, we'll have a final smash up.
Yeah, before you do, I was going to say, we're having difficulty, it seems to me, to getting young people interested in athletics. What brought you blokes to athletics? What is the lesson here? Who said to you, you blokes are going to be good at this, and encouraged you to do it?
Oh, it certainly wasn't the money.
No,
obviously.
I don't know, insanity, I think. For
insanity?
Yep.
So we're going to find insane kids
and
for a start.
Kids lacking intelligence.
Lacking intelligence? No problems there.
I didn't want to work.
Who don't want to work?
I don't want to work, so Dad said, you either run fast or you're working, so I chose to run fast.
How about you, Mark? No, that's all right.
Nothing.
That's right, combination of the two, mate.
Oh, a bad memory.
And bad memory.
Because, you see, when you train and you physically be ill, you want to come back the next day and go, oh, it didn't happen.
Yeah, it didn't happen.
And then just do it again.
No, I understand that.
That's good.
Wow, that's great that they're...
There's a lesson there. That
they drive themselves to sickness. Mm. It's fantastic. Obviously, the Commonwealth Games isn't that far away. Do you think you'd be turning out as a foursome in the Commonwealth Games again?
I think so. I mean, we're a pretty young team, so this is really one of 10 years still to come for me, and I'm sure the boys will be in the same boat as long as those requests that we previously requested
come through. And the Americans, are they beatable in Beijing? I reckon they are.
I think they are.
They look soft to me.
They are. You see, that was their third fastest time, so they're on their way down.
Yeah.
Well, let's have a final plate smash together on the count of three. One, two, three. And before we go, there's pins all round. There's the souvenir of your time with us, the 24-carat gold pin. It's a three-pronged pin-off. Congratulations to you all.
Thank
you made Australians across the nation very, very happy last night. Roy?
Yep, you get the toilet paper, blokes, the golden shovel, wipes. Enjoy.
And can you please thank three-quarters of the Silver Bullets, John Stephenson, Mark Ormrod and Clinton Hill. So we sadly come to the final segment from the final show of The Dream in Athens. And Roy, it's been a fantastic journey.
It has.
A number of people have got onto us via the sites and contacted with emails. And sadly, we haven't been able to bring many of them to you. But Roy, there's a couple before we go.
Yeah, just very quickly, H.G., and thank you to everyone who has emailed us. One here from Peter, Adrian and Julie. This is in Moorabbin. They say, we feel that a vigorous probe into the standard of umpiring at the women's basketball gold medal match is critical, given the debacle we witnessed last night. I'd agree with you. We were robbed. We were robbed totally. I thought it was appalling refereeing going on, giving the Americans a victory. And I don't know, we do need a probe. I think money might have exchanged hands. I'll let you know. Secondly, Tony Montano from Sydney says, I was wondering what your opinion is of athletes wearing sunglasses before races and during races. He says, personally, I think it's rubbish. I would agree with that. I just think it looks stupid. And it's been a real blight on these games. Athletes at night wearing sunglasses. I mean, it just chits me.
It's all right during the day, of course.
During the day, you expect it.
Yes. And finally, from Lutz.
Yes.
Gavin Lutz in Canalpin, South Australia, televised the drug test sampling.
What a good idea.
See who can put most in the bottle, who can fill the bottle the quickest, and judges
can... Make
it an event. That's right.
Make it an event.
Indeed, make it an event. And so, Roy, the final thing we usually do is a medal tally each night, and you've got one to sign off.
We do.
From the Games of the 28th Olympiad.
Indeed. And just before I do that, mate, well done. Another great job. It's been a real privilege to sit at your side once more.
Thanks very much.
Our medal tally, little battling countries who punch well above their weight. Well, there's only one. Australia. 17 gold, 16 silver, 16 bronze, total of 49. Congratulations all.
As we sign off from the Games here in Athens, there are many, many people who make this show possible, both here in Athens and in Melbourne, who don't get a chance to stick their heads on television. Usually it's only you and me who stick our heads on television. And as we leave you here in the Games of the 28th Olympiad and the Dream in Athens, can you thank them as well? Bye-bye from Athens. Bye. See you in Beijing. See you. The Games are over. Enjoy the closing ceremony. See you in 2008.
Step to his soul. passion and courage it takes to be there. The spirit of freedom alive in the air. Whenever the running man awakes to challenge to free.